Welcome to Excel Works video series. This is part 3 of the demonstration of Excel Advanced and Unique Partial Differential Equation Solver, PDE Solve. In part 2 of this presentation, we described the shown multi-region 3-equation PDE system and demonstrated how to model and solve it with PDE Solve in Excel. In the following, we will show how to optimize the model to predict experimental data. To enable PDE Solve in Excel, you will need to download and install Exilab Calculus add-in from excel-works.com. Here I have plotted Phi2 from the obtained solution for the initial values of beta and MC at X equal LC, which is at the interface between the cathode and separator regions. On the same figure, I've also plotted some measured values for Phi2 at the same location and different times. Clearly, our solution model does not do a good job in predicting the actual measured data from the experiment. Our objective here is to find optimal values for beta and MC so our model can accurately match the actual data. Beta and MC are parameters for the PDE equation system we are solving. Beta is the coefficient for the function AX, and MC is the off-diagonal term for the mass matrix shown in red, which couples the variable time derivatives on the left side of the equations. Solving this optimization problem is quite easy in Exilab in just 2 steps. First, I will define constraint formulas which measure the error between my numerical and measured values. I'm going to move that plot below so we have some working space. I can easily do that by defining my first formula and then using Excel autofill feature to complete the rest. I pick up my first value from the solution for Phi2 at time equal 0.1 and then subtract the corresponding value from the measured values. Note that in this version of Exilab, I need to use the criterion function ArrayVal to select a value from the solution array for the purpose of defining a constraint. I can generate the rest of the constraints using the autofill feature of Excel. The second step is to solve for beta and MC using the function NLSolve. I allocate an array to hold the solution. I insert my NLSolve formula. My first argument to NLSolve is my constraints that I've just defined. My second argument is the design variables that I want to optimize. They are beta and MC. Note that I am using Excel parenthesis syntax to combine the two references, beta and MC, into one reference for the second argument. Now I run this as an array formula by pressing Ctrl Shift Enter. The solver spins for a little bit and then reports the shown solution. I can now copy the new values for beta and MC over the old values as numbers. Excel recalculates the sheet, and now, as you see, our model predicts perfectly the measured data. Next, I would like to demo more advanced features of the solver and show how to enhance the solution accuracy. My goal is to verify that the flux continuity boundary condition on Phi2 has been satisfied. The second derivative of Phi2 is undefined at X equal LC and LS, where we have a sudden jump in the property K, but we expect the ratio of phi to x just before and after the interface to be 2 at x equal LC and 0.5 at x equal LS. To show this, I need to report phi to x in the output solution just before and after LC and LS. I do this by specifying custom output points for x shown in the orange range and add the nderiv key with the value 1 to the solver options shown here in the green range. To enhance solver accuracy, I also added the key max grid spacing with a value of 1e-5 to ensure my grid node spacing does not exceed this value. And I've also tightened the relative tolerances for Phi2 and 3. Next, I have to run my PDE solve again, passing in the new shown arguments. The new results are shown here. I have zoomed around X equal LC and LS and computed the ratios of Phi2x before and after. The ratios shown on the right indicate the continuity condition has been satisfied. We will show this live in Excel next. Here's my updated solver formula with the optional arguments. I can run it again by pressing Ctrl Shift Enter. Obviously, I had to allocate a larger array to hold the solution now that we are reporting the first derivatives as well. The ratios of Phi2x just before and after the interfaces are approximately 2 at x equal LC and 0.5 at x equal LS as expected. Note that Phi2x is undefined at the exact interface. Thank you for watching the third part of this PDE Solve presentation. You can find more solved calculus examples at excel-works.com. For any questions, feel free to contact us at support@excel-works.com. Thank you.